Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of GCC Compiler, that is GCC Compiler version 14 on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to create a simple Hello World C program and how to run that using GCC Compiler on our console. Should watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if these videos are really helping you, then please do like the video, share this video, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. That really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. So now to install the latest version of GCC Compiler, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and you need to just simply search over here GCC 14 download and hit enter. And that's going to show you all these different links. So here you need to go to this GCC W64 download, the sourceforce.net link. So when you click on that, it's going to redirect to the official site of SourceForce.net. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. So you can directly use that link to land over here. And once you are here, it is scroll down and you can see we have all this latest release version for our latest version of GCC compiler. So you can see this is the latest version, which is version 14.1.2 at the time of making of this video. They have also released another sub version on version 13. So a project required version 13.3 can use that version 13. For now, I'm going to use the latest version, which is version 14.1.2. So I'm going to just simply click on this folder and it's going to start downloading our latest version of GCC compiler. So you can see it is rightly started downloading. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. And you can see that our latest version of GCC is rightly downloaded over here. So just simply go to that folder. So here is our GCC version 14.1.2 folder, so rightly downloaded. So this will be a zip file. You need to unzip this. So just simply right click and click on extract all over here. So that's going to show you this screen. So click on extract. And there you go, you can see it is rightly started extracting. Again, let's wait for a couple of minutes and welcome back. So all the files are rightly extracted over here, so you can close this folder. So here is our extracted folder. So if you go inside that folder, you can see all these files, right? So what you need to do is you need to just simply rename this folder and make it something, you know, a bit shorter. So you can remove this part and you can only keep like GCC version 14.1.0. Alright, so after that you need to, you know, just simply cut this folder and then you need to go to your C drive and just simply paste that folder over here. So our folder is now rightly over here. So go inside that folder and then go inside our bin folder. And here you'll get lot of files and folders over here, right? So what you need to do is you need to click on this address bar. Then you need to just simply right click and copy this GCC version 14.1.2 bin folder path. Alright, and after that you need to go to search and then you need to type environ over here. So that will show you this edit the system environment variables. So you need to open that and then you need to click on environment variables over here. So that will open this environment variable window. Here you need to go to path and then you need to click on edit. And that will again going to open this edit environment variable window. Here you need to click on new, then right click and paste that folder path over here, that bin folder path. Alright, so after that click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now if you close this entire folder, you can minimize our browser also. And now if I just simply go to search and type cmd to open our command prompt, and here if you just simply type gcc space dash dash version and hit enter, you can clearly see that our latest version of GCC version 14.1.0 is successfully installed, and that's why it is showing this prompt over here. Now let's quickly write a simple hello world program and run that on our console. So just simply something like give cprog folder name, go inside that folder, create a new text document. So let's give the text document name as prog1. And I'm going to change this .txt extension with .c. So just simply click outside and click on yes. So there may be cases when you don't see this file name extension like .txt or .c. So what you need to do is you need to click on this view and then you need to hover over show, and then you need to enable this file name extensions. Alright, you can also enable these hidden items. Alright, I'm going to show you why you need to enable that. So what you need to do is you need to go to view, then show, and then you need to enable both this file name extension and hidden items. Alright, enable these two. So once you enable these two by just simply selecting, then you will be able to see this type of file name extensions over here. So next you need to open this in a notepad file. So open this in a notepad file, and here let's write a simple hello world code. So hash include stdio.h int main, then bracket open bracket close, and within curly bracket what I am going to do is I am going to just simply do printf hello world over here. Hello world, I'm going to end the bracket, and I'm going to return 0 over here. Why I'm returning 0? Because we have created an int main method, so that is expecting an integer to be returned. So I'm going to return 0 over here. So after that, just simply go to file and save this file. So our program is rightly saved. Now go to your address board and just simply type cmd, so, and hit enter. So that will going to open our command prompt right at this location, cproc folder location. To run, just simply type gcc your file name, which is prog1.c. So prog1.c, hit enter, and you can see that our file is successfully executed. It is not showing any error, so that's why it has also generated this a.exe file. So this a.exe file will be also going to be generated for you guys also. So all you need to do is you need to go to view, and then you need to enable these hidden items. Once you enable that, you will be able to see this generated file. So this is the file that you need to run. So to run, in our command prompt, just simply give that file name, which is a. So just simply type a and hit enter, and that's going to show you the output hello world on our console. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of GCC compiler, and you can start writing your C or C++ program. So all the steps will be same for C++ also, like I have done for C. Alright, I have also started Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I am posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel, and also if you are interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.